listener is a rare commodity. We all want someone to listen to us, but we are not ready to listen to others. Fact is that whether we are a parent or a child, a spouse, friend, or a colleague, we all need someone to listen to us and not just only hear. We all know that hearing is a physical process that helps you receive sound waves and noise by ears, whereas listening requires full concentration where you can make another person feel more comfortable. My name is Amir Hassan. Today, I'm going to talk about the power of listening and how it can change the personalities. Some of us are afraid to speak up because we fear humiliation from what would happen if I say the wrong things. In organization and in our personal lives, we experience that most of the people are going through the same feelings. That is the fear of humiliation because we don't allow them to speak and we don't listen to them. At the end of this video, I will also give a small tip: how can you improve your listening capabilities? It was around 20 years back, I was at one of the international airports waiting to board my flight. I was sitting next to a gentleman who looked a bit excited, confused, and panicked. I started reading a book, and then suddenly the gentleman said something to me in his language, which I could not understand. So I told him, "I'm really sorry, I don't understand your language." He glanced at me briefly, then he stared at the ceiling for a few seconds and approached me again and said, "You," and kept quiet. So I started reading again. After a few seconds, he tried to say something again, but did not manage to say a word other than "you," followed by a big pause. After a few attempts of interruption, I stopped reading my book and turned myself to face him and stared at him. I wanted to show my anger, my frustration, but he thought that I was listening to him and completely ignored my frustration. This time he turned around as if he made up his mind to finally say something to me. Then he said, "You made in the country mentioned my country name?" That kind of a question I was not expecting and could not answer. But then I realized what he meant and smiled and said, "Yes." I saw a feel of relief on his face as if he had crossed the most difficult hurdle in his life. He then continued to ask me a few questions in his own way and I kept answering him. Within a few minutes, he was a different person, a confident person. I took it as a fun story to tell then, but later in my life, I realized how important it was for him to be able to communicate his thoughts to someone, a stranger, and become more confident, strong, and relaxed. I also realized that how important it was for him that someone can listen to him and not make any fun of him. Words really don't matter as long as you understand the meaning. Stop showing frustration, show sympathy, and start listening. This will help you in your personal and professional lives. It will reduce not only stress, but also create an atmosphere of trust and openness. What you need to do is simply to listen to them, whether they are your parents, child, a spouse, friend, or a colleague. Believe me, you will feel a positive difference in their lives and yours. You will feel satisfaction that will help that you help someone crossing the hurdle, maybe the most difficult hurdle of their lives. Do try to be a good listener, but don't expect results immediately. It takes time. It will be challenging and difficult. I give you the simple tip. Close your book and show your willingness with compassion and you will see the difference. I hope that this will not only help you identify your strength as a listener, but improve your way of thinking as well. If you want to discuss, please send me an email and I will assist you. Thank you. Why don't you share your experience with us so that we all can learn from each other? Till then, stay safe.